approach to how they do this. Going back to Tom Parsons talking about that throttle, that thumb throttle. He actually broke the head of his radius off. He dislocated his scaphoid, part of his wrist, went up into his thumb, dislocated and tore all the ligaments in his lunate bones. To give you an idea of the severity of that injury, and if you're thinking, like, why did a wrist injury take somebody out for 11 months? That is why. It was more than just a run-of-the-mill broken wrist. Taking a look at Jared McNeil right there. He competed back in 2015 in Austin. Speed and style. Whoa! There's our first sighting of what we call a turn up these days. Those are awesome out in the hills when you get a good hip or somewhere you can kind of turn up and into a hill. But he's taking up the ramps. He's twisting that bike. He's almost got that bike vertical as well. The Australian Jared McNeil with his style. Yep, going with seat bounce as well. Style. You know, like I said, he has a heavy moto background. And yeah, look at that shot right there. He's looking all the way backwards.
Almost looks like he's going into a 360.
Backwards.
He's backwards at that point.
Yeah, that's pretty insane. Like you said, how they get it back, I don't know. But
out of his system, at least out of his stomach, is what we saw in that video.
Yeah, so look at that view right there, just completely hanging off under the bike. Kind of kicks his foot off to get his back end going around. Like I said, that's just him working the bike around. Look at that, just twisted around. That's pretty much full 180 right there.
Where his head is at that point, he's completely looking back.
Yeah.
At the fans in it.
Slow-mo always makes the whip look cool. You can just see how much goes into it.
It almost looks like he's going in.
You were on a BMX bike, that would look like a barrel roll flare right there.
That's just mind-boggling.
Awesome, yeah.
You get into that position and then you're able to come back on the street.